We want to solve and graph the inequality and then express the solution using interval notation. The method for solving a linear inequality is the same as solving a linear equation, except when solving a linear inequality, if we multiply or divide by a negative, we must reverse the inequality symbol. So looking at our inequality, the first step is going to be to clear these parentheses. So we'll distribute the 3. So we'll have 3x plus 15 minus 8 is greater than x minus 1. And notice on the left side we can combine these two terms here. 15 minus 8 would be 7. So this would simplify to 3x plus 7 is greater than x minus 1. Now we do have variable terms on both sides of the inequality, and we do need to have the variable on one side. So we can either subtract x on both sides of the inequality or subtract 3x on both sides. Since normally we prefer to have the variable term on the left side of an inequality, we'll subtract x on both sides. Well, 3x minus x, or 3x minus 1x, would be 2x. So we have 2x plus 7 is greater than, this would be 0, so we have negative 1. Now we have a basic two-step inequality. So we need to undo this addition as well as undo this multiplication. And we always undo addition and subtraction first. So the opposite of plus 7 would be minus 7. So we'll subtract 7 on both sides. So now we have 2x, this would be 0. So we have 2x is greater than negative 1 minus 7 is negative 8. And now we'll divide both sides by positive 2. We're dividing by a positive, so we're not going to reverse the inequality. We will have x is greater than negative 8 divided by positive 2 is negative 4. So this is our solution expressed as an inequality. But now we also want to graph this. So to graph x is greater than negative 4, notice that negative 4 does not satisfy this inequality and therefore is not in the interval. So to show this, we make an open point on negative 4. Again, this indicates that negative 4 is not included in this interval. And then for values greater than negative 4, we have an arrow to the right. As we continue to move right on the number line, we would approach positive infinity, and this is helpful to write this interval using interval notation. We'd have the interval from negative 4 to infinity, and to show negative 4 is not included, we make an open parenthesis to the left of negative 4, and then for infinity, we always use a rounded parenthesis as well. Now we've expressed the solution as an inequality, as a graph, and also using interval notation. I hope this helps.